You gonna come back on here? You gonna get in?
He can talk from.
Oh well, he can. Yeah, we good. Let's get it then. All right.
You start.
Yeah, I thought about starting.
All right. Oh man, don't just start like that though. Hey, boy, yeah, we back at it, y'all. Yeah, we gonna get right to it, man. These playoffs.
The Minnesota Timberwolves game one beat the Denver Nuggets 106, I think, to 109. Yeah, I mean to 99.
Yeah.
Something like that. Real.
Man.
You seen game one. Jokic had about 30. Anthony Edwards had 43.
Yeah.
Michael Porter made 4 threes. Jamal Murray did not have as good as a game as he probably needed to.
Not a nigga was good.
Yeah.
What do you think about game one, Real, of this series?
Man, I think that the Timberwolves is something to look out for. The Timberwolves going to be straight in this series. They're proven with this first game, I think, because that was a statement beating them at home. They beat them at the house, and, you know, the worst place to get beat at is at the house. Yes, sir, man. But, yeah, it was a good game, and it's going to be a great series, though. That's one that I'm looking forward to.
But, like, who do you got? Like, how
who do I got in the I'll probably say I'm going with the Timberwolves because I need them to just win because –
But y'all not beating them,
yeah,
dude.
Rather,
you gotta stop saying that.
Yeah, for all that don't know, Dallas Mavericks is my team. Yeah, I'm letting y'all know. Yeah, yes, for sure. Been that since Finland.
It's not. It hasn't been that.
Finland.
But that's cap. Kay. That man, biggest capper I know.
Yeah, so.
Timberwolves in six, man.
What the fuck?
Man.
You calling this shit? But. I got the Timberwolves, too. I just like the matchup, bro.
Yeah.
I got the Timberwolves in.
This is the first time I've seen Jokic sweat.
Jokic always sweat.
No, I'm saying like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
for those of you that don't know, Jarrell is a Mavericks fan. And he, for some reason, thinks that the Mavericks are going to the NBA Finals. Now, my opinion on this is they're not. Simple as that, they're not going to the NBA Finals. Now, if you ask Jarrell why they're going to the NBA Finals, he would tell you they would.
Because I believe in Kyrie and Luka.
He believes in Kyrie and Luka. Now, the fact that those are just two people and they gonna have to go against the whole team doesn't matter, yeah. Jarrell.
Oh no. We got a few people that's going.
You don't though.
Yeah, we got some people that are gonna come.
Danny Gafford just lost his matchup to Zubac.
Oh yeah, but We came out of this series. We good.
Without Kawhi.
Yeah, it don't matter. We passed that. We going to get to the promised land. That's all we
No, you're
yeah,
not,
we
bro.
Are. We going to the Western Conference Final for real. I think. No, I don't know. We might not, though.
Y'all not going to the finals.
I can see the Western Conference.
Yeah, I think we'll go to the Western Conference Final. And I can't for certain say that, you know, now I'm hoping that we end up playing the Timberwolves, and it could go.
You don't
want to
play the Timberwolves, bro. You want to play the Nuggets.
I don't want to play the Nuggets.
You don't want to play the Timberwolves.
I don't want to play the Timberwolves either, but I'd rather play them than the Nuggets.
No, you wouldn't, bro.
For a certain win for them.
This what? What is that? What?
No, I'm saying like that'll be a for certain win for Denver. Like they're gonna beat us.
The
like,
Timberwolves just spanked Denver. What are we talking about here?
Yeah, they beat us in the regular season as well.
We're not talking about regular season. We're talking about tonight. Did you not see what happened tonight?
Oh, yeah.
Think about y'all team against that.
Man.
Who guarding Ant-Man?
Man, it's going to be hard.
Derrick Jones.
It's going to be hard.
Who guarding Cat?
It's going to be hard.
Who guarding Rudy?
P.J. Washington guarding Cat.
Come on, bro. P.J. Washington guarding Cat. Daniel Gafford got to go at Rudy Gobert and get him off the boards, bro. Zubac will get 15
right.
boards.
They going to have to get right, man.
They not going to get right, man. It's over with.
Yeah.
Stop.
They been
Stop with the Dallas shit,
been
man.
Shocking me, man.
Stop with the Dallas shit, bro. We know that the Clippers fell apart.
Everybody thought that Luka wasn't going to show up on the defensive end, and he been putting up here lately, though. You know what I'm saying? That was the big issue at one time. Luka don't play no defense.
He don't.
But he will. What's
that? How you gonna say he showed up on defense?
He don't, but he will. Though. But he been playing better defense than in the past, though.
He was kind of mid all series, bro.
He was mid. He be mid this series against OKC. His ass is gone.
He can't be mid
on no defense, especially with OKC.
But he's not playing on defense, bro.
But they gonna go try to get him to guard Shea.
He gonna have to.
If they switching the shit. That shit not.
Get out.
Yeah, all of them gonna have to play some defense. And with Kyrie, they just gonna have to facilitate that match.
Jalen Williams is guarding him.
Yeah, I don't see.
Or Lou Dort. Nigga, I forgot about Lou Dort. Come on, bro. Dre, your shit is done. Your niggas done. Nah. These niggas not injured like Kawhi was.
Yeah.
They putting Lou Dort on.
I'm putting Lou Dort on Luka.
It can go either way.
Just so I can get a little leverage underneath them.
I think they putting on Luka.
It can go either way. Like,
but before we get all the way to the second round, who you got? The Cavs versus Magic.
Magic gonna beat them tomorrow.
Cavs versus Magic.
Game 7, bro.
Crunch time, I think Donovan Mitchell gonna... I think he should step up. If he don't, then... that's just gonna be saying something about his mentality as a player. Like, he gonna have to come hard. Like, that's the last game you gotta win. So, clutch moment, you know. And, like, you know, with the Magic, it ain't like they can't win. They can win because they, you know, they've been doing their thing as well, so.
Yeah, they young as hell. But yeah. I feel like they don't supposed to be this good already.
Right.
But you need to make it to the second round. It'll be crazy. It'll probably be his second year, bro. But I got the Magic because my guy went to Duke, bro. So.
Yeah.
I'm going with the Magic regardless.
Fuck Paolo Banchero. I know he didn't mention his name.
Hey.
Fuck Derrick Lively, too.
Oh, man.
At
come
least
on,
my
man.
Guys
hey.
In the playoffs.
And mine is, too. Derrick Lively. Hey, but
fuck
look.
Shea.
Hey, all right.
Fuck Shea.
All right. Shea. Yeah.
Get this nigga out of here. Jamal Murray, too. Neither one of your guys make it to the same.
Carlin the Towns.
Yeah, now Carlin the Towns.
We got niggas all over, cuz.
You one of the ones.
We got niggas all over.
Hey,
you know, man.
But I'm going to tell you, though, like with Dallas, you know, like a lot of people.
Hey, Jalen Williams went to Arkansas, bro. You got to remember that.
A lot of people ain't getting look at that credit that he deserves.
Who?
Even though Shea is good. I acknowledge Shea. Shea is good.
He's great.
But he need a better team around.
Bro, they were the number one seed. You gotta quit this, bro. That was the number one seed.
They were.
So and Dallas is better than them?
I ain't gonna do that. Cause I think they got a better facilitated team. But at the same time, I think that the team that Dallas have right now is gonna be a team that they gonna be able to build with. And we don't
Dallas
need
Dallas got a better supporting cast than OKC?
Support.
Say yes, so I can say cap.
No, I ain't gonna say that because they got a whole lot of weapons over there on OKC that they can use. But
so what
at
do you
the
mean,
same
you,
time,
what do you mean? So your statement is false then.
Which statement?
You just said that they didn't have a good team. Basically, is what you just said. You just said it.
No, I said they have a better facilitated team than my team though, like in Dallas. They better than
you said. Shea is good, but he need better players to play with.
He do.
They're the number one seed in the West.
He do. He needs some better players with him. He got what he need, but he could use some help.
Drill, you just sit there and say.
He gonna need more help than what he got.
You just said Luke and them gonna go to the finals because he got Kyrie.
He gonna need more help than he got.
And the Dallas Mavericks not?
Yeah, we're going to need some help. But at the same time...
How y'all equipped to go to the final, but OKC is not?
Man, we got inside game over them guys.
No, y'all don't!
Well, we shall see. I'm letting you know, I'm letting you know what's been getting us through. Yeah.
Daniel Gafford better than Chet?
No, but he going to shut Chet down. We're going to see. I'm telling you. He gonna shut him down. He gonna shut him down.
He didn't shut. He didn't shut Zubac down. How the fuck is he gonna shut Chet down?
We advanced. We advanced.
Y'all advanced because of what?
Because we play good as a team. Because
the nigga gonna do. That's what that is.
Man, Galvin don't got us. I don't need that man to score
30. Y'all advanced because Kawhi was hurt.
Well, we all injuries is accounted for. If you get injured during the playoff, that's your business, dog. Look, hey.
So stop acting like y'all was just killing. Y'all killing because this nigga didn't play good.
Y'all need to eat right. People need to eat right.
But eating right has nothing to do with that.
If you're going to be healthy.
Do you eat right? Do you eat right?
As an athlete, you're going to have to eat right.
Do you eat right?
I don't eat right because I ain't an athlete.
Have you ever got hurt, though?
Hey, not too much.
My point is, have you done athletic things? Got hurt?
I got injured doing a layup one time, bro. It was funny. So I would go into that, man. I did a layup, man. You know, on the wheels on the go. You know, they got the wheels on the go.
Oh, you talking about one of them type of goals.
You know, I went up for the layup and rolled on the wheel. And the wheel rolled on me. I fell down and twisted my ankle, man. Damn,
how fast you
was? Like 3-4 had to take me to the house. It happened on Tony Jackson's house. Shout out to Tony. I ain't no count.
What the fuck? You was running that all
right. Yes, sir. I wouldn't know.
In other news, like
that,
my
man.
Guy.
This nigga, bro.
This nigga here, fool.
Nah, but I honestly, I'm just a true fan of Dallas Mavericks. I've been a fan, though. Since Dirk Nowitzki, you know.
And yeah, he love to talk about Dallas like they finna fucking win, and they gonna fucking lose.
Hey, people didn't think we were gonna win in 2011. We were playing the defending champs. Who was?
They wanted to finish. This is what I be talking about. Man, you do not know what he be talking about.
But then Miami, then they win. It probably wasn't the year
it was
before
Kobe
that.
But Kobe won the year
it
before.
It wasn't the year before that.
And what did Dallas do to them? What did Dallas do to Kobe?
It's on him.
Huh?
It's on him to the career.
They swept his ass.
Man, look.
In the first round. I don't hear y'all saying shit about that. Damn.
Man, he ain't really have much to work
with. See, here we go. He just won a championship year before that.
They started letting Luke Walton.
Stop it. You got to quit it.
That was the year Andrew Bynum did this shit, didn't it?
Yeah, he elbowed J.J. Barrett and then took his shirt off.
Hey. I remember that shit.
Who they didn't have back?
Man. Well, we need it.
My point exactly. Shut that up. I got a bone to pick. Y'all Kobe fans and Michael Jordan fans had that same damn energy when Kobe gets swept and MJ got swept. Had that same damn energy.
Kobe didn't have that supporting cast.
Stop it. We had this argument over here 30 times, but you got to quit it.
Now the KD shit. Like, if Kobe had that supporting cast, come on now. Kobe ain't let
you. I ain't about to talk about KD.
I am, because that's a fucking shame. He one of my favorite players. I don't give a damn who you is. Yeah, if you got...
LeBron didn't have that help.
Man, that's what I'm saying. If LeBron didn't have that help, KD don't need no pads, man. KD can't get no pads.
But ain't about bringing up KD. You already know what he did with some snake shit.
Some KD shit now. KD... Man, you my guy, but you slowing the fuck out. You need to get it together, brother.
I ain't gonna lie,
because bro. Because that's a shame, bro. Bradley Beal, Booker, that should have been a... Come on, bro. You should have been still in there. Y'all ain't 58 years old. Come on, man.
Brother got swept twice in 3 years, bro.
You know.
And so. I remember I bet money on this nigga versus the fucking Celtics, forget this shit.
KD good, no doubt. But he should have stayed at the Warriors. That was crazy. Don't listen to what people saying, KD. Don't let them get in your head. It's a mind thing, man. It's a mind thing. LeBron, go back to the Cavaliers now. If you listening.
No.
That's who built you. It wasn't the Lakers. That's Kobe's legacy, bro. Kobe. It is.
Come on.
Kobe's legacy.
Stop it. You got to quit it, bro.
It's Shaq's legacy.
Who the greatest Laker?
Kobe.
Nigga, you capped out.
Where the statue bigger than Iverson's?
Nigga, that's in Philly. Nigga, that's not the Lakers.
Man, it's Kobe.
Magic is the greatest Laker, nigga. Stop
it. Magic wish he was Kobe. He came to see Kobe.
Yeah, he did come
but
see Kobe.
Kobe was a fan of Magic, though. No cap. There's no cap. But to me, even though Kareem was better than Magic, to me.
No, the fuck he... Nigga, what?
Kareem Abdul Jabbar. Yeah, he was better than Magic.
No, he wasn't.
Yeah.
No, the fuck he wasn't.
Magic wish he was Kareem.
No, he don't.
Man, he probably...
He's like the greatest Laker. Do you...
What? Without Kareem... Kareem got a ring before that, man.
He did.
He was on the Bucks.
Yeah. Who was his point guard?
Oscar Robinson. Yeah.
Another Hall of Fame point guard. Seems like he need what? Hall of Fame point guard, correct?
Man, look, it take. Right. Hey, sometimes it take two to tango. They say.
First year is a rookie. What'd he do?
Man, you gonna need some.
First year is a rookie. What'd he do?
You know what he did? Passed the bitch to Green. You know what he did?
Man. I know what he did. Went down there, played center, won the championship. Kareem wasn't there. He was hurt.
That nigga ain't play center. Magic played a few games in a free position.
What you mean he didn't play center?
I mean, a free game, yeah, he did. But
he did the jump ball and everything.
Yeah, he was doing it.
The game is up, cuz. We can pull it up right now, cuz. You don't think we pull it up?
That nigga is playing center, backing niggas down.
Yeah, but see, Kobe made...
Small ball. First small ball lineup, cuz.
Kobe made centers not want to be centers, man. He dunked on them, made them folk. Man.
Who?
Kobe. Kobe was a LeBron before LeBron was.
Don't you ever in your life say that again, but stop this shit. No, he wasn't.
He was.
No.
LeBron wasn't.
No,
a fan
but
of Kobe.
Stop it, but you got it.
You saying LeBron?
No, but stop it, no, nigga.
LeBron, if you listen, you a fan of Kobe? Bro.
No, he was not a fan of Kobe, nigga.
Be honest, man.
No, but he was a fan of Jordan for sure.
He's a fan of Kobe.
Nigga,
Kobe
was,
came
after
Jordan.
What?
He came after.
Jordan. He came after Jordan.
He liked it.
He passed that torch.
Who?
Jordan passed that torch to Kobe.
He didn't.
Who he passed it to other than Kobe? It wasn't Shaq.
Why wouldn't Shaq?
Because Shaq didn't get a ring in the Magic. The man didn't get one.
What the fuck that mean?
He was on the team.
What they got to do with anything?
He could have had a ring. He didn't get it without Kobe. He didn't get it. He didn't get it until he came to L.A. with Kobe. He wanted to go where Kobe Bryant was.
Nigga, I'm so sick of niggas like you. Do you understand? He got... What year Kobe get drafted?
96.
96, correct?
Yeah, 96.
What year Shaq go to the Lakers? 96, I'll help you out.
Okay, 96, all right.
You think he's looking at a rookie and saying, Kobe going to be real good as a rookie. I'm going over there with him.
Nah, he just...
He didn't give a fuck about Kobe. He didn't give a fuck about Kobe. He said this shit. I just seen 108. He wanted to up Alonzo Mourning.
He was playing on the field Jackson. It was Kobe fucking Bryant.
You see what I mean, bro? No, nigga. No. No. 96. So, Phoenix Jackson is still in Chicago.
Okay.
See what I mean? You know what he's talking about. Phoenix Jackson is still there. Jerry West is the GM.
Yeah.
He went over there to up Alonzo Mourning's contract. He wanted, I think he like 120.
Contract.
Yeah, Alonzo Mourning got a $100 million contract. They were trying to get Shaq like 98 or something. He said, no. He went over here with Jerry West and the Lakers. Jerry West said, we just drafted this kid, Kobe Bryant. He going to be a hell of a player. Shaq said, yeah. Give me that contract. He was going for the money, nigga. He didn't give a fuck about Kobe.
Well, when he seen what the fuck the Kobe Bean Bryant was capable of, he wanted to stay there for a few more years. We know that for a fact. And Kobe
We don't know that for a fact.
Kobe didn't want him to leave either, though.
Yes, he did. But do you realize they have a whole interview?
Yeah, but they were doing the thing, though.
They were doing the thing.
You know what I'm saying?
But so, Kobe definitely needed Shaq. Stop acting like Shaq needed Kobe.
Either one. Or both of them. They needed each other, though. For real. It really takes that. It's just like...
So you think... Listen, so if you put... You take Kobe out. You put in Ray Allen. They don't win shit.
You said
take Kobe out, put Ray Allen in that system. They don't win, you don't think?
Hell no.
No?
No.
Why?
Not even a young Ray. No.
Why?
Because he wasn't Kobe.
Nigga, Kobe wasn't Kobe when he was young.
I'm talking about, man, even Kobe when he was young, man, the one with
nigga,
the Kobe.
He didn't even start.
But when he got in.
When he got in, what happened?
He turned into Kobe Bean Bryant.
No, the fuck he didn't. It took him years to turn into Kobe Bean Bryant. So
we watched that. And it was greatness. It was greatness, though.
Kobe we watched this nigga getting in the air ball. That's greatness.
That was greatness when he air balled to Utah.
Man, look.
There was greatness. Stop.
It was greatness when he hit that 81 and won the game.
Shaq wasn't even there. Yeah. See what I'm saying? You just saying random shit.
Yeah, but Shaq ain't got to be there. I'm talking about Kobe.
Kobe won half hour rings if it went for Shaq.
Yeah, he would.
No, the fuck he won. Stop. That's cap. Capped the fuck out, Jarrell. Stop it.
He got two of them out of these left.
With Powell, nigga. Why the fuck he ain't do it by himself? Don't y'all tell Brian? Why he ain't get one in Cleveland the first go-round?
Shaq ain't do it by himself, though. He went to another, he had to go where Wade was. I can say that. Yeah, because he had went right there. That man had to go there.
What did the Heat do before that? How good was that?
I mean...
Trash, nigga. They were trash. Fucking trash. Stop it. Shaq went over there, helped Wade get a chip. What the fuck was Kobe doing?
Man, Kobe was doing that.
Going to the fucking house. That's what he was doing.
Kobe was doing the thing.
He was doing the thing, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, trash as fuck.
Nah, they were dethroning Kobe like they doing LeBron right now.
They was dethroning Kobe in 07, nigga?
Well, I say it was after 2000 and... Nah, well, probably 2011. Yeah, that went...
Because Kobe just won back-to-back chips. He said they dethroned him.
They dethroned him in 2011. Man,
boy, get your ass out of here, bro.
The Mavs are dethroned.
Man, after the Mavericks, it was the Miami Heat, and they turned his ass up 4 years straight. So, and then after that...
When Lakers and Kobe was going against the Cavs and Bron, that was beating their ass. What the fuck are we talking about here?
Shit, we were beating the Cavs there. When, you know...
It's 16-6, bro. Kobe beat Bron six times throughout his career. Stop with this fucking comparing Kobe to LeBron shit. Kobe was great. I'm never going to say he ain't great. He's not LeBron, bro. Stop it. Just because this nigga make bad shots don't make him great, bro.
Nah, he making free throws. Kobe always...
Yeah, he making free throws. Okay. So the fuck what? It's a lot of... Nigga, J.J. Redick make his free throws. He ain't better than LeBron. What the fuck are you talking about? That's dumb shit. J.J. Redick making free throws? He better than LeBron?
He do make it.
Is he better than LeBron? Yeah, nah. But get that dumb ass theory out of here then. Steve Kerr make your free throws. Is he better than LeBron? Would you pick Steve Kerr or LeBron?
Hell nah.
Well, get your dumb... That's a dumb ass theory.
But look, but...
Would you pick Steve Kerr or Shaq? No, you ain't. Get that dumb ass theory out of here.
Nah, I ain't gonna pick Steve Kerr.
My point is exactly. So but stop coming with them. He gonna make his free throws. Man, dumb ass shit. Y'all niggas be on some dumb ass shit, man. This Kobe, LeBron, and Mike shit.
Man, LeBron is a great player, but he...
didn't have to get mentored by a lot of niggas to be great.
Like Kobe
and Mike
moments,
did.
But I think in clutch moments...
He just needed more help.
Who?
LeBron.
Yeah, he needed a little bit more.
He just played with more All-Stars.
Yeah, he's a better team player.
Sure. We already know that.
Yeah, he's most definitely a better team player. But
even though he don't play in the system.
If Kobe had that, if he had that attitude.
Had a system to implement?
Bro. Who? People got to start with this shit.
Start with what?
LeBron get these niggas fired every other year, bro. It's never going to be a system with LeBron. LeBron don't get off.
Who LeBron got fired beside David Black? Who you think?
He's getting niggas
fired. He didn't get Darvin Ham. He didn't get Darvin Ham fired. Who?
Vogel.
You think he got Frank Vogel fired?
Yes. I think he got Ham fired too.
I think everywhere this nigga go. The nigga tried to get Eric Spoelstra fired.
Yeah, he did do it. He wanted Pat Riley. Yeah. But the nigga wanted Pat Riley.
Nigga tried to get niggas the fuck out of here. It's never gonna be a system with LeBron. It's the end of his career now. Shit done. Man. The nigga never played in the system. It's just not gonna happen.
I mean, They give him a little bit more. I mean, give him more power than he needs. And
what
they give LeBron a little bit more power than he needs, bro.
When Phil Jackson left the Lakers, bro. When Phil left the Lakers, how long did each coach stay? You tell me. Kobe was there. Man. Are we saying that Kobe got them niggas fired? No, we only do this shit with Bron.
No, I ain't gonna sit up because at that time,
Did Kobe get Mike Brown fired?
Could've.
Did he get my D'Antoni fired?
I ain't gonna lie, he could have though. It depends on if they
ever since Phil Jackson left, they've been firing these coaches 2-3 years. They fired. So that this shit just didn't start with Bron, fool.
Now this shit been happening.
But I think AD know had a problem with Darvin Ham too, though. I think they got his ass.
They might have had a problem with Darvin Ham. I don't know. I'm not in the locker room. Cause all I know is, I keep seeing niggas saying, Brian, I got the co-fired again. Who nigga, they've been doing this. What?
Who you want y'all to coach to be?
Mark Jackson. They're not going to hire him, though.
Mark Jackson, okay.
They're not going to hire him. Yeah. It don't matter if they hire God, nigga. If they don't fire Rob Pelinka, we're going
to
be ass.
They said Rondo's supposed to be y'all coach.
I don't care if it's Rondo, J.J. Redick, Mark Jackson, Ty Lue. If they don't fire Rob Pelinka, we are going to be trash.
So what does it... What is his job?
He's a general manager. He makes the team up. Okay. And he keeps getting these bum-ass niggas. And then they tell him, oh, this team is great. And you know what I say? No, the fuck is not. We should have been traded D-Lo. Why we didn't trade D-Lo? We knew that D-Lo wasn't going to do shit. We knew D-Lo was trash.
You start having
Hachimura had 1 year series against Memphis. We seen what he did last year against these niggas Denver. We seen Jokic cook his ass. So you knew we were finna have to go against Denver, and you didn't go sign another center besides Jackson Hayes, my nigga, but you supposed to be GM motherfucking year, dude. You knew Joel Embiid, Jokic, Giannis, all these niggas is big man. If AD get in foul trouble, you have nobody to hold these niggas. But you went and signed Gabe Vincent for $33 million, man.
Joel Embiid, man, go on, come to Dallas, man. We need you, Doc. We need.
Bro, he's not coming to Dallas,
man,
bro.
Man, look.
That'll be the worst decision of his life.
Not the worst.
Luka don't even really want to pass the ball, my nigga.
He will if it's Embiid. Shit.
Do you know how?
You got to have somebody to pass that joint too, man. And Gaffer, he just gave him a little bit more, you know, easy.
Nigga, will you stop bringing up Gaffer, brother?
Man, I mean, I ain't going to throw him up under the bus, though. Gaffer is better than most centers that's in the league right now because they don't really play
but see,
ball.
But like, see, it be shit like that right there. No, the fuck he not. He in the lower percentile, my nigga. I swear to God he is.
Yeah, but, I mean.
He's not in the lower percentile?
Yeah, I mean, preparing too. Like, he ain't no Embiid 30, or nothing.
32, it's 32 starting centers. What would you place him?
Okay, to me.
It's 32 starting centers. What are you going to place them out of 32?
I put them probably number 26, probably.
What the? Nah, you got the nigga too low. He better than that.
Or 20. Maybe 20. If 20? I can name better 20, I mean 19 so better center. Matter of fact. He probably ranking right.
Let me just look at NBA teams in period. And I'll tell you who they starting center is. Because I ain't going to be able to think about all of them.
Because he's not better than Steve Allen.
Okay. Hornets starting center is Mark Williams, correct? Yeah. Is Daniel Gafford better than Mark Williams?
Yeah. To me. I don't even know.
I'm taking Mark Williams.
I think I'm taking Mark too.
Grizz the starting center. Boy, it was Steven Allen. Now it's Jaren. Because Gigi has the four, right?
Jaren playing center.
So I think Gigi at the four, correct? And then Jake Lavery.
Jaren Jackson.
Doing it at the three.
Yeah.
Jaren Jackson is way better than. Yeah. Okay, that's not even.
Take it, Jaren.
Yeah.
Is Bam there four or there five?
Bam five.
No. That's not even a. Yeah. Joel, that's not even a. Yeah. Porzingis is their five, correct? Because JT the four. That's not even a. Yeah. Rudy Gobert, that's not even a, come on now.
Anthony Davis,
come on now. Let's not do that.
We beat
Zubac. What Zubac is? Yeah. That's not even a.
Well, he at
Portland. You taking Aiden or you taking Gafford?
I'm taking Gafford.
Yeah, because you a dickhead. Man. Yeah, you a dickhead for that. Yeah. We know you biased. Yeah, no.
Yeah,
Andre Drummond or Gafford, who you taking?
DeAndre Aiden a bum.
He a bum?
Yeah, that man a bum. That man got a whole ring.
I bet you money that trade Gaffer right now they eyes cold for DeAndre.
If Gaffer was on that team with the Sun, man, they would have got that ring that year. I said it.
2021?
Nigga, is you dumb? Nigga, you dumb? Man, can't guard no fucking Yanni. He can barely guard Zubac.
He can't guard Zubac.
He can guard Giannis, my nigga. That was money wins for putting that nigga on Giannis one-on-one. Man. You cannot put this nigga one-on-one. With a head full of steam, nigga. You're going to get a foul every time.
This nigga's crazy, bro.
This nigga's biased, bro. Everything is biased with this nigga, bro.
So, Kings.
Who the Kings?
Sabonis.
Come on now. Miles Turner, nigga. Come on now. Knicks. All right, so you probably got the Knicks. I think that's Hardenstein.
I think he's better than Hardenstein. Like, a little bit.
Right.
They like the
Brooklyn. City. Who's Nick Claston, nigga? Fuck out of here. Who the Wizards center? Is it Alex Len?
He better than him.
Well, no, Alex Len on the Kings.
I thought he got traded.
He big ass on. We'll give him that. Rockets. Damn, it man, is Sengun. No. Spurs. Hell no. Nah. I ain't even got to say his name. No, y'all got the Warriors, though. I bet the Warriors is Draymond Green or some shit.
Yeah.
Y'all got that. Jazz, Walker Kessler. Yeah. My nigga, your nigga done. Jonas Valanciunas, your nigga done. Where we at?
Clint Capella, he better than his ass.
Who better than Clint Capella? Gafford?
Yeah.
Boy, get your dumb ass out of here. Hell no. Who the Jared Allen? Get Gafford the fuck up out of here. Magic. Wendell Carter, get Gafford the fuck up out of here. Cause who is he better than? I thought maybe you was being a little selfish. My nigga, who is he? Isaiah Stewart. He might got Isaiah Stewart, maybe. But Isaiah Stewart, no, that's Jalen Duran. Get him up out of here. Get him the fuck out of here.
Brooke Lopez.
Get him the fuck out of here. Nigga, your nigga is trash.
Who is the Raptors in there?
Precious Achiuwa. So he got him.
And the Trailblazer, they son is
DeAndre Ayton. Bro, you can't say that. Bro, I promise you right now, if they said. He'll
get that man to work.
What?
He'll get DeAndre Ayton.
Chip playing center, probably.
He's center. Yeah, OKC center.
That man ain't like Roy Hibbert, you said. You said
what?
You said Roy Hibbert would trash. I believe DeAndre.
Oh, my. This nigga said. No, he not trash, bro. He don't play. He listen to me. Let me say this. He better than Gafford.
Yeah. He gonna get you 20. He gonna get you at least.
Gafford is not going to get you 20.
Nah, he not.
So stop with the shenanigans, my boy.
He not. Gafford, you gotta get your.
Who is he better than? He's not better than Jokic.
Daniel Gafford, man. If you listen, man. You
who is he better than, Joel?
He better than Precious.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Because I don't believe in you, Daniel Gafford. I think you can be the next King Martin.
He better than Precious Achiuwa.
Damn.
And Isaiah Hardenstein. He's 20. No, he's 30 on his damn list of sinners. He's 30, bruh. 30. Damn. 30, Jarrell. 30. Who the Wendell Carter? But come on, bro. So stop it, bro. Who is
the Warriors?
Yeah, okay, Draymond.
He better than Nurkic, bro. I got him over Nurkic's ass, bro. I don't like that nigga.
I'll give him Nurkic.
Nurkic is, bro. I hate that nigga. I don't know why.
But it's not another nigga. He's 29.
Gafford just gotta get him a jump shot, man. If he ever develop any type of mid-range, he got to get that.
Gafford got to get a game, period.
Man, that man be dunking all on folk, man.
He be booming, nigga.
Man, you catch that man open line, he going to bam on you. Oh, God.
He going to dunk on Chet this year.
Man, okay. I'm telling you. You must ain't seen the Islands. We the new Island Club, bro.
We the new Island Club.
Yes, sir. Lob City.
Nigga, if you ever say that shit again, bro, don't do that.
Man, hey, we gonna catch some of them highlights one day.
Bro, you gotta quit it, bro.
Highlights been crazy.
You gotta
fucking
quit it, my nigga.
The boy
Daniel Gafford is so fucking trash, dude. He's so trash, I can't even buy highlights of him for this series that he just had. There's like no There's none.
He ain't really been doing shit in the
Because he's trash. He ain't really been Nigga doing just had five game. Games. He couldn't get no highlights.
Yeah, like 8 points. 8 points.
And you talking about eight ain't better than him.
See, he bammed in that jump right there.
Fuck
out
of here. Fuck, I'm not watching this nigga dunk. He's 7 foot. He's supposed to dunk.
He's supposed to do more than that.
And he don't. So stop saying the nigga good. Yeah, nigga shouldn't even be starting. Derek Lively should be starting. He's not even the best center on his team.
I'll take him over JaVale.
You can take who over JaVale?
Him.
Gafford?
Hell yeah.
Nigga, you drunk. Man, you drunk as fuck, nigga. You get some corn whiskey before you came here.
Number two, yeah.
Right, yeah. JaVale go back to the Lakers, bro. When JaVale go back to the Lakers, because we're going to go get him. We're going to get JaVale this year.
And y'all going to lose.
No, no, against who?
If y'all get
that, come on, stop it. AD going back to the folk. Yes, sir. And y'all niggas just finished. Dallas is done. Dallas is done.
Man, we got Lively, too, though.
He's the best center on y'all team.
Yeah, he younger, too.
So Daniel Gafford ain't even the best center on his own team.
We gonna find a spot for him. We gonna work it out.
We gonna find the nigga start. What do you mean yeah, you gonna find a spot for him?
We gonna work it out.
Nigga trash.
He gonna be the 8-man next year.
Hey man, in other news. So we gonna spend all day on this. Jarrell and his nun. We're gonna have a segment called Jarrell Nonsense for the Day.
Man.
Kendrick Lamar has been killing Drake in this rap battle. Jarrell, the music god.
Oh look, I just wanna say first. I was the only nigga here to pick Kendrick in the beef. These are facts. I think this nigga picked J. Cole.
I think I did pick Cole. Hey, I'm not going to deny it. Yeah, I don't remember, but Kendrick. I might have picked Cole. Hey, and for the record, when Cole made that record, he was killing niggas.
Nah, this shit was nice. But,
and then the nigga was like, man, I think what happened was Kendrick called him like, hey, bro, you really don't want to be in with this shit.
Future got them records.
He probably did.
Future got them records.
Yeah, he just waiting to release. You know, he
you think Future like dissing for real? Like,
man, I think.
Hey man, I know. Hey man, this is a good time for me to plug my own podcast called Let Tez Rant, and this is a tad bit of what you're gonna get. Future is not lyrical at all, bro. Yeah. he is top five though.
Yeah, he would.
As in a vibe, I guess. Lyrically, no.
See, most people wouldn't call Project Pat lyrical because they don't understand his words. But Project Pat got a story to tell.
He do,
and
bro.
It's real deal. Like, if you can comprehend it, I mean, I'm vibe with it. And if I vibe with it, it's going to stick with me. You going to fuck with
it. But you vibe with a lot of trash-ass shit.
I mean, certain trash shit. Some shit got to grow on you. You know,
nah, I remember he had us listen to that little kid from Florida. Cause
yes.
Man, big extra plug. Y'all was not fucking with that man before I was bringing him on. Like, and you know.
Drill, you played one song of that nigga.
And you were like.
I said the nigga all right.
Yeah, you like.
I said he all right.
Yeah.
The nigga was all right. What the fuck you talking about?
But to everybody else, I mean, he the youngest guy that been coming up.
It been a couple niggas you showed.
Yeah. Drill, okay, you 1 for 50. Come on, bro. Don't do that.
1 for 50.
Who else in the last year that was bumping?
Man,
because the nigga from Haywood, he was not bumping.
The nigga from
Jackson, the BJ recorder, he was not bumping.
Oh man.
The nigga from Summerville last year, he was not bumping.
Oh man.
You got so mad that we said that nigga was bumping. You said Furio was trash.
He did.
And Furio sounded 30 times better than the nigga you let us hear. You said, yeah, that shit. You ain't even listen to the song. The beat player said, yeah, that nigga track. You ain't even listen to the song. Yeah,
he
that nigga.
Did, I swear
he didn't listen to the song. He had the beat. Yeah, that nigga track. Yeah. He was mad as hell. He said, yeah, that nigga track.
I remember.
Nigga didn't even listen to the song. Yeah, he said, yeah, that nigga track. He was mad as fuck.
He didn't even start rapping.
I don't even know if I got a song with that Furio guy. I done listened to a few of his records.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna play. He don't get no play in the whip. Like, I ain't gonna lie.
Nigga, nobody playing the niggas that you play in the whip, and they will.
Not yet.
Jarrell, if you think that any one of them niggas that I just said, the nigga from Jackson, Haywood, or some of it is finna blow, no.
Yeah, I mean, you know.
No, nigga. No.
To each his own. But when everybody get their hit, you know, sometimes it take a little bit longer for others. But, you know.
You know me, cuz? Like, what the hell, cuz? It was this one, right?
Is that what
this the joint you listen to, right?
I think so.
No, it had to be this. It had to be this.
I don't think I remember this. I remember that little boy, bro. That shit was funny as hell.
That little boy, bro.
That nigga from Florida, bro. I don't know.
Oh, yeah.
What happened to him, Drill?
Man, I'm not sure, man. They got so many artists out, though. And, you know, some of them, they go in like everybody got their own little story to tell. So, you know, I don't even get.
You acknowledge that you won for 50 on artists?
Nah, man, Big Egg the Plug, that one.
Yeah, he your one.
Like, I can show you a lot of artists, though, but like,
you can show me other artists.
Real quick to cut shit off, though.
I be honest, and you don't.
Nah,
you tell niggas that's trash, they good.
You be real quick to cut shit off real quick.
Because it's trash.
But when it's trash, you gotta give it a chance to be trash, though.
Whoa. Nigga, did we not just establish that you listened to a beat and said a nigga was trash? We established that.
You did do that.
You said, yeah, that nigga trash. The beat just started, Jarrell.
The nigga wasn't rapping.
The nigga hadn't rapped. He just moving his head.
But the nigga Fulio, I don't think bro was.
So Fulio ain't better than Fumi?
Not me.
Nigga, you dumb. What is you talking about? Not me.
If y'all listening out there, man, y'all give Fumi.
Fulio not better than. Then Fumi?
Not me. I ain't gonna lie. I think he doing just as much as that man. Like,
what?
Keep going, bro.
This is no disrespect to you, Fumi. I don't care if you see it or not. It's no disrespect to you. You ain't on 4011, even you know that. Bruh, stop it.
He probably know that. He probably know that.
He gotta know it.
Yeah, I mean, monetary.
Now he trying to get up there. Hope you make it. All success. I'm not gonna play your music, but all success to you, brother. All success to him. Man,
You listen to
you just let us listen to the finesse NBA YoungBoy shit that was trash.
Listen
that
to Fredo shit. Ruthless.
That shit was ass.
You ever
heard of him?
No, I haven't.
You heard of Fredo Ruthless?
Nah. Hey guys, this is what we're gonna do. Check me out. Listen to me. We're about to react to Fredo Ruthless.
I never heard of this.
Man, y'all gonna react.
We finna react to Fredo Ruthless. Now I want y'all in the chat.
Shout out to Fredo Ruthless.
If this shit is bumping. But this is what I'm gonna do first. Wait, hold on. Shout out to BJ. 1 through 10, how good is this song we finna listen to for Fredo Ruthless? Man. Matter of fact, I'm gonna pull up a song right now. You gonna tell them. And then the artist gonna tell you.
I'm gonna get.
So I can let y'all see what we be having to go through with this nigga real.
Fredo Ruthless. Yeah, I get
where you from?
He from Nashville. He from the Ville.
This nigga gonna be trash. Which song you want us to listen to?
You can go to Plain Jane. You can go to that Jane.
This Jane right here.
Y'all think he just had too long did leave. All right,
guy.
He's on the endless.
Yeah.
We're about to right now live. React to Fredo Ruthless, Plain Jane. It been up for a month, got 20,000 views. It's a dude in the white hoodie.
He an upcoming artist, y'all, man. Don't try to compare him to Drake. He an upcoming artist.
Nigga, we compare Fumi to Fulio, not Drake.
I'm not comparing him to nobody.
You heard this song before.
Fumi and Fulio, though, that ain't that far-fetched, though. You know,
That's very much far-fetched. Good anyway, or... ass.
Yeah.
Plain Jane, what did you rate this song?
Plain Jane, I get eight.
He said this song gonna be an eight.
We need to react to a 10. This the thought, because he said it's an 8.
10.
I already one know this 10. Shit not.
It's not gonna be an 8. It's gonna be a fucking 4. But we're gonna listen. If it's 8, I'm gonna say you're right. It's 8. I'm honest. You're not.
I would give it 100.
Here we go. We finna react to Plain Jane right now. Listen, guys, listen. Wait, I gotta go to it. Here we go. Turn it up a little bit. I gotta let the whole thing play.
Hey, I'm just up plane, change just how I'm feeling. Taking risks, doing the same thing, and they be the prison. I like finding your main thing, I love her adrenaline. I'm in the studio with Bane, we reminisce. Fresh recording shit, you know he making history. I done the same thing wrong, but I can't let him get to me. Put that fat in my head, don't know why he ain't get to me. Throw that special with three in his face, he grew up differently. Throw that special with three in his face, I laid him down. I was number 13, and he was OG. I had to call my mom, I was walking on feet.
What the fuck?
Blood on me, she like to rub on me, she eat my meat. Yeah, a cat, don't talk speed, she got me clutching my feet. I know the baddest bitches that fuck for her feet. You can be fucking with me, fuck with my nigga, I'm keeping it peak. Nobody in the building, we keep it discreet. Call my phone whenever you need. I just got a call that told me 50 died. Shit made my stomach weak. How fuck with
this shit?
If he was alive, he would've come to me.
No.
This is an 8.
I say, this is one of the best songs you done referred to a nigga for.
Yeah. But not an 8.
It's... But this is way better than some of the other shit that you just said.
Yeah, I mean, you know, that, I mean, I listen to a whole lot of different shit, though. I mean.
This was 8, though?
I gave him an 8. I gave him an 8.
Because you fuck with him.
I mean, but.
You know him personally?
No. I done seen him, though. I done seen him before, but I don't know him personally. Yeah.
But this not ass. I thought it was going to be ass.
Nah, he got that. Better songs than that, though. But this just...
Don't do it, bro. You just said do it.
See, that's just, where it go wrong.
Yeah, because you just said this was an 8.
No. Like, when I said it, like, people, once you hear an artist, you want to refer to that song. You want to be able to refer to at least a few songs that they did good, you know. But, like, you know, he got a free track. But a lot of the stuff that, like that jump right there, that jump was hard.
I'm back.
Yeah, that jump was hard.
Fred Ruthless, I'm back. This is 10.
Man, if you gonna react, cause you gonna have to react to Jig, man. You gonna have to react to Jay Cry, cause you gotta react to Cud, man. You watched this video?
Man, I haven't watched it yet, bro.
Yeah, you need to watch that jump. Go on, play the I'm back though. We do that joint and then we get back.
Jump out of my goal.
Jump out of the Gino.
Frank. I see it.
Yeah, it's John Hart.
It's because BJ directed it?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, he directed it, but the man got some hard records, though. They were fucking with him in the Ville when I was up there. So he a Ville vet. Like,
so you hung up with the name?
Uh-uh. Hanging with him?
You said you was.
No, I wasn't hanging with him. I done seen him. He done came up to the to Cheers you and shit. Peace on the Germany Bill. I'm
like D cock and all like saying. Told me that day should be home already. Fuck up that bitch, that shit on the daily. We pull up dumb like on me and they cash invoice, how you gonna pay? Rags and riches, yeah, we finna make it. Chill by the mic, I'm calling bitch rude. Peace on the cheese, I can make you feel it. I'm like D cock and all like saying. Told me that day should be home already. Fuck up that bitch, that shit on the daily. We pull up dumb.
Would you say he lyrically inclined?
He comparing to, cause a lot of the young niggas that be rapping, bro. Like a lot of young niggas down, they don't be going like that. Some of them got his wordplay a little different. His wordplay a little different.
You heard bars then?
No. He got a free little.
I'm talking about any song. You heard bars?
I free. I heard a free.
That mind said, just met this bitch, she trying to put deep throat on me.
That's a bar?
Not yet. You gotta complete a bar.
The next line has nothing to do with the bench.
I'm not sure what the next line was.
This shit didn't go together, nigga. I ain't gonna lie, he just said some random shit. I'm gonna keep it. This nigga gotta be freestyling, bro.
Drake is getting killed by Kendrick. We went off on a tangent, but Drake is getting killed by Kendrick. Hopefully, Drake will concede in this battle. Drell, you think Drake can make a comeback in this battle?
Man, I think Drake needs to just chill out. He needs to play it safe like he been doing.
What you mean play it safe? You talked about the nigga family.
He need to play it safe and just chill out.
He been talking about the nigga family. It's no more safe shit.
Man, look. Kendrick, it's good that he putting out records and stuff, man, but put out some shit that you can get you some albums on, man. Like, come on. Like, Drake, you know, he doing his thing, but album sales, we all know where that's going. We already know.
We do know that Kendrick and Drake is about on the same level.
Yeah, kind of. But we also know
they not on the same level, big dog.
And look, it's too deep for me to even talk about on the camera like that.
What you mean?
It's too deep to talk about on the camera like
they not on the same level when it comes to
albums. I mean, yeah, you can put them on that same caliber, but I'm saying like, I say Drake got a little bit more. I don't know.
You're the music guy, man. We asking you.
Yeah. Well, it's kind of tricky, cause, I know Kendrick got a lot of supporters. Kendrick got a whole lot of supporters, like, mad supporters, and it's supporters of our complexion.
Right.
And he speaks highly of us, you know, so mostly our supporters. That's why I'm getting there. I just want to get there.
Right.
And if you following me, I just wanted to know if you following me.
I'm not.
It,
I'm
okay, not. That's I bad. See what he's saying. It's bad then. Because you need to Drake. Follow.
You saying that he got... I know you're
get,
saying...
Cause I want you to get what I'm saying, because I'm not trying to lose any... fans or anything in the comments.
Saying white people don't fuck with them?
Well, look, you have your way of saying it, and I have my way of saying it.
If you said white people don't fuck with him, but white people do fuck with Kendrick.
I mean, they do, but they don't fuck with some of the shit that Kendrick might say. He's like Kanye.
As in what?
He's like Kanye. You don't know what he gonna say. He ain't Drake. You can pretty much predict what... Because
he's gonna care about being famous, though.
You can pretty much predict what Drake
gonna say. It's like, it's different. Like, Drake is... They make it Drake for everybody.
Yes, sir.
You know, so they can boost him to...
Yes, sir.
It's really what the mind
is. That's all I was getting at, like. But at the end of the day...
So he's bigger than Drake then?
Because...
If only one race is messing with him and he...
He... I don't know, man.
If you got...
I don't know.
All races fucking one nigga and one race fucking with... Mostly one race fucking with a nigga and you on the same level?
Neither one of them niggas the GOAT. I ain't gonna lie. I don't even know why they having that conversation amongst themselves, because it's stupid to have it amongst
themselves.
It's
not, though.
It's kind of is.
It's not, though.
Because they ain't the best. They ain't the best. To be the best, you gotta beat the best. Right now, though.
Man, I don't know about no
GOAT. The era is over for one.
But there's still some people out here that can... Go lyrically with them.
Yeah.
And not only go lyrically with them, but also have catalog.
Who got a big catalog of Drake you finna name?
Chance the Rapper.
You did
not only not nah, but look, you might not listen to Chance.
It ain't even about me listening to Chance. It's the fact that you said he got a bigger catalog than Drake. He does not have a bigger catalog than Drake.
I used to listen to
was setting that up for you to say Wayne, M, maybe even Busta Rhymes.
Yeah.
Chance the Rapper? Nigga, no. You think Chance the Rapper got a bigger catalog than Drake?
Nah,
Chance the Rapper.
By itself? By itself, Drake by itself. I ain't talking about features, cause Chance don't really do that.
Yeah, we talking about just Drake album.
I'm talking about Drake, period.
Just album,
Drake,
but Drake. Just the catalog just is Drake. His album.
Not features. I'm talking about Drake.
The song that's on his album.
Yeah, yeah.
Not collab album.
I'm talking about Hot Bling shit. Like, I'm talking about that.
What is Chance Hotline Bling? What is Chance God playing? What is Chance God's playing?
Chance.
His biggest song is DJ Khaled's song. Is DJ Khaled's song, is it not?
Hell no.
It's not? Okay. I'm wrong then. What's his biggest song then? If it's not the DJ Khaled song, he on.
Man,
we can look it up right now.
It had to be on the coloring book, his biggest song.
Probably. I remember Cocoa Butter Kisses.
Bro, at the song, you don't want no part. That's his song by itself? Or is that DJ Khaled?
That was a
That's what I'm saying. That's his biggest shit, though.
Yeah, that.
You don't want no problem with no problem with me.
Yeah, I don't think that was it.
That wasn't his biggest song?
It's one of them.
That's probably the biggest song he own, I think.
That's what I'm saying. What the fuck are you talking about?
I don't know if that's his shit, though.
That's what I'm saying. Is it, because I know Wayne on it, but is it his song?
I'm not sure about that.
It's his shit.
Yeah, that's his shit.
Got 175 million.
Yeah, but that ain't fucking with God's plan, though.
No, it's not. That's not fucking with Hotline Bling.
Nah.
Juice. Oh, my God. Bro, I remember
Cocoa
that shit.
Cocoa Butter Kisses. They ain't get that radio play like that. Shit like that.
Bro,
know?
This shit. Bro, I remember listening to this shit in school.
Yeah, but, I mean, you know.
So try again with Devin, brother. No, not kidding. Not him. I thought you were going to say Wayne. Wayne do have a catalog.
Yeah, Wayne is undeniable for me. You know, because even with how big the song
is. I don't think. Is that song No Problem bigger than Miss Me? Did you even go back and listen to that when we were talking about it?
Miss Me.
Miss Me a Little When I'm Gone.
Miss Me. That with Trey's on?
No, nigga.
It's just him.
You remember that song?
Yeah, I remember that.
No Problems. Yeah. No Problems probably a little bigger.
Yeah, I
No Problems was a big ass song, bro.
It was a big ass song. I just didn't know it was that old Drake.
Was that man was he was coming tough though. But it, like rumor has it that Safari wrote a whole lot of stuff for him.
No.
And Nicki too.
Nicki, I didn't hear shit about him.
Yeah. I didn't hear shit about him. Safari wrote for a whole lot of folks. Like, and then Rick Ross wrote for that man plenty of time, too.
I believe that.
Yeah.
Rick Ross, a big writer behind, you know what I'm saying, behind the scenes. That's how he make a lot of his money. Like, even R&B records. This nigga don't sing, but he can write a song. Like, you know. When you like but, that, you can make that money.
So you going
the
with
same.
Chance the Rapper as a better catalog than Drake?
I go back on that. I ain't gonna lie. I go back on that. But
I asked him on music. What is Rick Ross really though?
Yeah. Rick Ross and Drake. Like, come on, man. Rick Ross. Other than Wayne, that's been Tupac and Biggie. Well, for me anyway. You know
who's
what I'm saying?
Tupac and Biggie.
Man, Wayne and Ross, bro. Anything you play with them on it.
My nigga, y'all see what we did with when we on this podcast. You just compare Ross to Biggie?
Yeah.
With rapping?
Hell yeah.
Is you out your fucking mind? Hey, cuz then would I be... Well, you got your own opinion, but I ain't going into it.
Man, Rick Ross is one of the coldest niggas that
he's
we
He's not
know.
Biggie, bro.
No, but
not with lyrics.
In this generation, that nigga is Biggie.
No, the fuck he not.
Who
no.
else is?
No.
Who else been like that?
No, bro.
Who else giving you that feel like that?
No, bro. That nigga don't give me that feel.
Nobody
that
is.
Nigga,
no, man. Bro. He's not Biggie, bro. Nobody can ever in life. No, bro. No, Jarrell. No. That's probably your worst take.
Yes.
Dice Pineapples. It might be. Dice Pineapples. Play Dice Pineapples.
I would get copyrighted to play Dice Pineapples.
Yeah, you just play a little snippet of the joint. But
you know even in stop hitting on all this new Ross, nigga. Even in Three Kings. Yeah. Freemason.
Yes.
He ain't rapping like Biggie. No, bro, don't do that.
Nah, I ain't gonna say he rapping like Biggie, nigga.
He ain't giving me the feel of Biggie, nigga.
That nigga giving you this time Biggie. No. Biggie was live and reincarnated today. Rick Ross will be that man. And Rick Ross got them balls, bro. That shit undeniable.
Listen to this, bro. I'm limited to the verse. Maybe I'm wrong. I could be wrong.
Cause I'm gonna play some after this. So fresh, dice pineapples, girl, my baby tastes the best. I nearly lost my mind. Guess it was a test. Swept off her feet and went and bought her ass a Lex. Paid it off cash, so I never wrote a check. Leave my cars at a crib. I'm just stunting on an ex.
Yeah.
Pussy's excellent, and I know it's sound a mess. I let her make her toes curl as I'm licking on her flesh. Sex all night, couple shots of Ciroc. Crib on the water, got LeBron up the block. Money ain't a thing, baby, welcome to the mob. Dice pineapples, talking diamonds by the jar. Bitch so bad, got me wishing. Wordplay, bro. Wordplay with that pen. That pen.
What bar you were playing?
Oh, look. Every last
you
a damn. Bit of,
come on.
Every
Dre,
last
gotta,
bit of bro.
Stop
every
it, dude.
Every last bit of
Cause, stop it. Every he last just, bit of this nigga just was talking about having sex. That's all he just did.
He wasn't talking about sex then.
At the beginning of that bar. At the beginning of that verse, it wasn't just about him having sex.
Some of it was.
I just said that.
Some of it was. But not all of it. Everybody said a little bit.
Nigga, ain't you even listening to it?
Oh, yeah.
What bars? You can't say all of it. And then I said, that for the first half, the nigga was talking about having sex with a bitch. He said, a pussy smell tastes like pineapples. What is the lyrical genius in that? But it's not no Biggie shit, bro. You gotta quit. You said you playing some good. Ross is compared to Biggie.
And Big Pun.
Oh wow. Oh, cause you didn't even.
Oh
have,
shit.
You didn't even have to go suicidal thoughts. I already know you're going. You didn't even have to go suicidal thoughts. You could have went to Niggas Bleed Just Like Us. You could have went to that. You could have went to fucking Juicy to match the shit you just played.
I wouldn't even want to match that shit though, cause he ain't never did nothing like this. What the fuck?
But you can go to I'm just playing. You could do all that shit. Dangerous MCs. But come on, bro.
Party and bullshit. Yes,
What's the lyrics on that better than what you was talking about?
What, party and bullshit?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was better than Dice Pineapple lyrics, Rick Ross.
I mean, they legendary lyrics, man. But
it's the fact that you compare Rick Ross to Biggie.
Got legendary shit. I ain't gonna
Ross do?
Hell yeah.
Legendary lyrics or songs?
I ain't every day on hustling, nigga. You play that shit at your game. Anywhere you play that joke.
Because I ain't gonna play this shit. Right. This ain't even fair. But. See, it 222. Nigga, that's not no fucking... Stop it, bro. You gotta quit it, Jarrell. I love you to death, bro. You my brother. I love you, man. But your damn take. 222. She in room 222. Yeah. That was hard as a bar.
You wasn't alive in that time. You
was I wasn't alive, Jarrell. I was a fucking kid. Jesus Lord. That nigga said I was a damn kid. Well, guess what? I wasn't even born to hear Biggie, and I know he better. What the fuck are we talking about? Stop. That's me that dumb shit that nigga say. You weren't even allowed to see Jordan play. Motherfucker is on YouTube.
Yeah, some of them kids be like, turn that Biggie shit off. I don't want to hear that shit.
And nobody plays Ross. Who playing Ross?
The kids that don't know Biggie.
Who playing Ross? Who don't know Biggie? Name a kid don't know Biggie.
But if a kid think Rick Ross is better than Biggie,
there's no kid
different. Yeah.
If I tell you what I'm gonna do tomorrow for you,
I'll
tell you what I'm gonna do to you for you, Drell. I'm gonna come out to your house tomorrow. I'm gonna tell Z. Hey Z, sit right here. I'm gonna let you listen to two songs. You tell me who rap better, Z. That's your nephew.
Yeah.
So who rap better, Z? And he gonna come in here and say A or B. I'm letting you know who A and B gonna be. A gonna be Ross. B gonna be Biggie. If you come in there and say B, I'm gonna say Jarrell, even your nephew know that Ross is not Biggie. All right. Come on, cuz. Come on, bro. Why you do that? Every day I'm hustling, fool.
Yeah, Biggie.
Nigga, that was a nursery rhyme.
Hustling.
Come on, cuz. You got.
This nigga a writer, cuz.
Big as a writer? What the fuck we talking about?
We don't know that. You. Hey. If you gotta look at them credentials. Hey,
fool. One thing we gotta stop doing, if we gotta stop. No. I told y'all I was gonna run this joint. Listen to me, fool. You gotta stop saying that one nigga is something, and then I say another nigga is something, and you say, we don't know that. Nigga, we don't know that Ross is writing all his raps. How we know he writing all them bitches?
Cut the credentials. You won't get your writing royalties. That shit a thing, cuz. When you write a record, you get paid.
So Biggie won writing records?
You probably if
Biggie won writing records.
It depends on.
We know he was writing right. For Lil' Kim.
Yeah,
he wrote for Lil' Kim and.
He probably did. He probably did.
What are we talking about here?
Nah, like we know he did though.
Yeah, he had a group.
And he wrote all that shit. So you think okay, he gonna write for all of them niggas and then not write for himself? Who the